Recently, I was invited to spend a day with the South Yorkshire Police Motorcycle Wing. Another day of interviews in a cold, damp garage. Well, actually, no. A day out on patrol, riding a pan-European, complete with blues and twos.
Okay, Chris, then, what exactly have I let myself in for here today?
Well, we never take anything for granted, so we're going to start off and see if you can actually ride a motorcycle.
All right, okay.
So we'll go out into the city, nice low speeds, have a look at you getting used to the bike, see if you can handle the bike, because it's quite a heavy lump.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll build you up, look at some basic positioning, basic disciplined ride, and then if you're going all right, we'll build up into some 40-50 limits and then go out to the national speed limits and look at some cornering.
Right. When do I get to put my blue lights and my doo-doos on?
That's if what I'm. If you're a very good boy and you buy lunch...
Oh, I can sort that
then
out.
Then we might have a look at some no-nos on for you.
All right. Well, is this the bike I'm using?
This is the bike you're going to use, yeah.
Fully marked up with the...
Pan-European, yeah.
All the bells and whistles and everything.
Yeah. Everything's there. You leave everything alone, apart from...
You're not going to tell me where the blue lights...
No,
where's the blue lights
on? You don't get to play with those until later on.
Right, OK.
PTT button for the radio. Okay.
Push to talk.
That's it. So you need one of our helmets.
Is that the headlamp flasher normally, isn't it?
Yeah, you would be normally, yeah.
Right, okay.
So we do. This is all commed up.
Yeah.
And we just plug that into this here, and then when you want to talk to me, press that, and you'll be able to hear me coming through both speakers and helmet.
Right. And I can talk back to you as well.
Yes.
Right.
If you've got time.
If I've got time. What do you mean if I've got time?
One of these.
I need one of them. Has that got police on the back?
Nope.
No. All right.
Not yet.
Don't get to keep it then, right?
We'll swear you in later.
Right, so where are we going first? City? Built
yeah,
up,
we're going to go through town centre, out on a nice, big, busy road, I know, where there's plenty of shops and students and pedestrian crossings and lots of stuff to make you work.
Right.
And then we'll go out a little bit further, up into the countryside.
Am I leading all the way, or are you leading? What's the?
You'll go in front to start off with.
Right.
Let me have a look at you. Don't worry about my position. You'll just ride for yourself. I'll dodge about, right. Have a look at your riding style. And then if we've got a bit of a problem, I'll maybe nip in front and just say follow on behind me.
And be no
so
problems.
Within half a mile, I'll be in front.
Hey, we'll see. Right,
okay,
let's get on with it.
And so, after a quick check of our comms units, it was out onto the city streets, with Chris constantly rabbiting down my ear. See what I mean? And I had another 7 hours of this to look forward to. But eventually, we left the city and headed out towards the countryside, where speeds increased and Chris kept on talking. Well, actually, his aim was to improve my observations, to make me look further ahead and be more aware of what was going on around me. Now, this might look like the perfect biking road, but unless you set yourself up in the correct position for the bends, you'll eventually run into trouble. And this was something that Chris was keen for me to get right. It's surprising how quickly you can progress just by being in the right place on the road. Then, after about 4 hours or so on the road, it was back to base for a quick check on my progress.
Okay, Chris, brew time. Much needed, I have to say. 4.5 hours in the saddle. Have I made all the normal mistakes?
Well, I've been doing a lot of talking, haven't I?
You do an awful lot of talking. I can't believe how much talking you do. Is it just because it's me you're talking?
Well, what happens when you start your course, obviously I'm trying to correct lots and lots of little faults.
Hmm.
So I'm talking at you an awful lot, trying to get your observations up to make you see stuff a little bit earlier.
You're driving me mad.
So the more I'm talking, the worse you're doing.
You'd be dying, but you'd be better if you just shut up and let me get on with it, because you're constantly rabbiting.
Yeah. What it is, it's trying to get your concentration, observation levels enhanced.
Right.
So that when we go out, first of all, you're running into stuff and you're kind of thinking what's in front of you.
Mm.
Well, what I'm doing is I'm looking down the road in time to see something, interpret that so I can tell you so you can react to it.
Yeah.
So by the time I've told you something, you'll react to it. I've seen it a little bit further.
Right, I see.
All right. So we're trying to bring the observations up.
Okay.
That's the main fault. And everyone exhibits the same fault.
Well, it's working. You're sending me deaf as well, but it's working. But, I mean, am I making the normal mistakes? What are the normal mistakes? What's?
Yeah, the basics that any rider will exhibit, and that's irrespective of being civilian or police officer. They'll come along and they'll be a little bit too quick.
their observations are low, and that means you end up running into stuff and you end up with an erratic ride. Mm. Whereas what we're looking for is, as you're changing your position, the change has to be nice and smooth, lateral movement.
You were saying about a swan.
Yeah, that's the swan syndrome.
To a
yeah.
swan. Go on, explain that to me again.
If you're trying to picture out there the swan on the river, yeah. and it looks all smooth and tranquil and calm, yeah? But underneath, what are its feet doing?
Oh, they're going like the clappers, won't
yeah,
they?
Yeah,
right?
That's right. So what we want is, from the advanced rider, we want a person to see the advanced rider on his bike, going down the road, in control, nice and smooth, lateral movements. Mm-hmm. But upstairs, he's thinking at 90 miles an hour.
Yeah.
What's right. that car going to do? Is that person getting in and out of the car? Brake lights, smoke from the exhaust. What's that kiddie doing? What's the dog on the other side of the road? And all this stuff's coming at you in time to put the bike on the right place at the road at the right speed.
Right, I see. Okay, so what I've got to look forward to this afternoon?
Well, we're going to do a little bit more work on cornering. We did a little bit earlier on. What we found is that you were going a little bit shallow.
Okay.
So if I just try and explain to you on here, so we've got a series of bends. Be nice bends, these, wouldn't they?
They'd be great then, wouldn't they?
Okay.
I'd rather not be doing them on a pan-European, though.
Yeah. So what you've been doing is, so we're coming down this way, coming to a left-hand curve, okay? So we need to get the bike out towards the centre of the road.
Okay.
And that's going to increase your view around the curve.
Yeah.
What you've been doing is, you've been coming at it a little bit too much to your near side, a central position like this. Then the last minute, when I've been, you know, if you realise, you've moved out. But then, of course, that puts you on a longer route round. What we want to do is get your view up, okay, and plenty of time, so you get your course sorted out back here. So we get a nice straight run in, okay, then hold the line tight going around the curb until you get to this point. You can see around the apex to where the road's going.
Mm-hmm.
Then at this point, okay, then we can drift back into the near side because we're going to be going into a right-hand curve. And again, you keep it near side till you can see around the corner, okay, and as soon as you can see around the corner, we can then modify the course to come back to a central position for your basic safety
right.
position.
I see.
Whereas right. what you've been doing, you're going into it a little bit late and then drifting across the apex. So you come at it here and you will be drifting across like that
right.
before you can actually see around the curve.
Okay.
So we just work on
racing
that.
Racing line, that's my excuse.
Yeah, but not
on a pan. Not on a pan European. Right, okay. So are we going to hit the city streets then this afternoon at all?
Well, we'll build a little bit more on the basics, go back out through town. Nice bit of
you know
heavy
what I'm getting
town
at,
work.
Don't you?
You want to turn the blue
I
lights on,
I want to turn
on,
the blue lights on at the halls, of course I do.
You haven't bought any snap yet, have you?
No, I haven't.
Oh, well, get some snap, then we might look at blue lights.
Go and get the butties in now?
Next door, yeah.
Right.
Good place.
OK, I'm off.
And yes, I did buy lunch. And no, I didn't claim it on expenses. But the afternoon saw us out on patrol. But police work is not all high-speed pursuits and bank robberies. There's the more routine jobs, such as issuing parking tickets. And, ooh, it does make you feel powerful, you know. Then we had a van which looked like its back axle was about to collapse. So a quick word and some rearranging of the load, and he was safely on his way. I even got to play with a laser gun, but I'll tell you more about that on another day. You know, I definitely learned an awful lot during the day. Chris started to talk less and less, so I guess I must have got better and better. It's certainly an experience having a policeman on your tail for 8 hours. But well worth it if it helps to improve your standard of riding. And in case you're wondering, yes, I did get to play with the blue lights.
Chris, what can I say? Fantastic.
You enjoy that?
I like the blue lights. If you'd have had a microphone in my helmet, I was going woo like a big kid. Fantastic.
You don't need the siren then, do you?
That's a great, what an adrenaline rush. Do you still get an adrenaline rush when you put the lights on?
Yeah, you've got to, really.
After all these years?
I mean, you're concentrating so hard on what you're doing, and yeah. it's not necessarily speed either. You're making progress, so you might not be going too quick, but your senses are so alert because you're looking for the dangers coming in left, right, in front of you, what people are doing, because they don't always react how you expect them to when you're approaching to them.
Right.
So you really, it's kind of like being in an arcade game. You feel as though you're actually inside the game because you're looking for everything happening, coming at you all this time. And you can't help but get an adrenaline rush.
It's great, I loved it. It was like a
as
big,
long as
big
it doesn't,
kid. As long as that doesn't take
yeah,
over
to
you.
Yeah, a red mist kind of thing, yeah.
Okay, so all day now I've been with you. All right, we've not done any proper police work. I mean, I've not done the things that you do in your normal daily life, but as far as riding the bike goes, go on, how did it go on? Tell me the truth.
What's that, Anne Robinson says? You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
Come on, tell me.
Well, we started off, didn't we, on that, you know, nice, slow, steady ride out, let you get yourself
Can I just say, first of all, I felt like I was on my test all over again.
Well, it's a bit of pressure.
It's bad enough having a policeman following you when he's just following you, but when you know he's watching you riding, and he's rabbiting in your ear like you were all the time, it's a lot of pressure on you.
No, it's about to be.
That's my excuse anyway, so I better go on.
Well, we started off, we looked at, you know, just basic positioning in a built-up environment, and you seem to get your head around that quite quickly, I thought. You know, a little bit of prompting from me to move the bike left or right, bring your observations up, and after about 15, 20 minutes, I could start to see you looking up and looking left and right and taking in more things coming in at you from nearer to and you know, out in the peripheries a little bit more. Mm-hmm. And you started moving the bike earlier, so the further we got into the ride, the earlier you were in the right position to cater for all these various threats that are coming at us.
Right.
Not that we had to take any action, but it's thinking about what might happen.
Okay. So a police motorcyclist, how long is he trained? Is it about 6 weeks or something?
It's the initial advanced course is 3 weeks. But bearing in mind, of course, you're in the saddle all the time.
Okay.
So you usually get an instructor and three pupils. So you have your turn on point, you go up to the bike, but you can't relax.
Right.
Because A, you've got to keep up with the guys, and B, the instructor's still watching you anyway.
Right, so they're doing hours and hours and hours, day after day after day. I've only done a day, 8 hours we've done on the bike. Am I average? What you would expect?
I think once you got your head around the bike and got used to the size, the bulk of the thing, and we then got into a more disciplined and systematic ride, it started coming along quite nicely. We looked at the cornering, and initially you were going into them a little bit late for your initial position, and you were tending to drift across the apex. We started towards the end of the day, getting to the position nice and early, and you were keeping that position nice and tight until you could see around the apex of the corner and then look for the position for the next corner. So it was all starting to come along quite well.
So I improved as the day went on?
Oh, definitely, yeah. Right. I would say...
Have I got potential then, you think? Is there potential for being a police rider?
Yeah, I'll put you on about day three of the first week of a three-week course there, which isn't bad on your first day.
Is that good?
That's good, that,
That's good. Right, fantastic. Well, is it? Have you got any more jobs then? I've had a great day. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Just over there is a power wash.
Oh, yeah. This?
That's your bike. You've got to clean it, mate. Right. And, oh, by the way, instructor's bike gets cleaned as well. Oh. So you've got two.
I'll go and switch it on.
We'll have a brew.